They were the very cute pets that you never fed after midnight. Gremlins starred in two movies, along with our next guest, who played Billy Peltzer.
What is it?
No.
It's your new pet.
Come on, Barney, be a good dog. You're kidding. Dad, it's really neat. Where did you get this?
Some little junk store in Chinatown.
Has it got a name, Dad?
Yeah, Mogwai.
What?
Mogwai. I don't know, some Chinese word. I just call him Gizmo. He seems to like it.
A classic. It's unreal. Since then, he's starred in hit TV shows including Melrose Place, Law & Order, Seventh Heaven, and Star Trek Voyager. Now, there are rumours Gremlins could get a third installment, so we thought we'd check in with the star of the iconic movie, a comedy horror movie, Zach Galligan, who joins us now via Zoom from Atlanta. G'day, Zach.
Hello.
How are you guys doing?
We're so excited to be talking to you, Zach. There's quite a bit to talk about. First up, though, are we ever going to see a Gremlins 3?
Well, I mean, the answer to that question is we're probably closer to a Gremlins 3 now than we have been in decades. Warner Brothers just decided to do a 10-part animated series called Gremlins Secrets of the Mogwai, which is coming out later this year on HBO Max. So you kind of have to think that if they're going to pour a ton of money into an animated series, they're not just going to do a cartoon. They're going to use the cartoon as a springboard to generate worldwide interest in a live-action film, because, quite honestly, that's where the majority of the money is.
Mm. Oh, fantastic. And it's something that I'd love to see. I'm a huge fan of it. The original writer, Chris Columbus, he said Gremlins 3 would stick to using puppets and ditch CGI. How would that work?
Well, the thing that they can do with CGI now that's so great is that they can use CGI just to do things like eliminate the strings or the wires or cables or anything that is used in the puppetry. So that really will enhance the illusion. But they can stick with the puppets now, and it'll be exponentially easier to do a Gremlins 3 because you won't have to do multiple takes or 17 takes of something like we had to do one time with Gizmo because you kept seeing the wires. So now even if you see the wires, they won't care because you'll just erase them.
Something a bit charming about the puppets in Gremlins.
Oh, I love it.
You actually beat out a ton of other high-profile actors for the role of Billy, including Kevin Bacon, Emilio Estevez and Judd Nelson. Is it true that it was your crush on Phoebe Cates that sealed the deal for the director?
Well, according to Joe Dante, the director, because I took him aside one day shooting and I said, hey, you know, what did I do to get this part? Because, you know, I want to learn and I want to be able to do it again when I try and get other parts. And he said, basically, there was a moment in the taped audition that Phoebe and I did together where I kind of put my head on her shoulder when the scene was all done and I let out a sigh. And apparently, when Spielberg saw that, because he had final approval for casting of the two leads, when he saw that, apparently, he looked at the screen and he said, look at that, he's already in love with her. I don't even need to see her.
Everyone was in love with Phoebe Cates.
That's it, yeah.
She was just an 80s dream girl.
But yeah, it's funny because it's such an iconic role and I couldn't picture anyone else in this movie.
No.
But you were almost in another iconic 80s flick, Back to the Future. You had auditioned for Marty McFly.
That's true. I mean, you know, one of the funny things about being an actor is there are a ton of movies that I auditioned for that I could have been in that I came very, very close for, you know, and by very close, I mean maybe the top two, three, four people. You know, Back to the Future was one of them. I don't know how close I really came on that one. The one that I really came close to that sort of is the one that got away was the Charlie Sheen role in Platoon.
Oh,
that was
wow.
The one that I thought for sure I was going to get and didn't get in the end.
What, it came down between you and Charlie Sheen?
Well, I mean, we only have 8 minutes here, but the short, super short version is there was some all sorts of legal problems with Platoon, and so they had multiple casting sessions. And the first casting session, I was pretty close to the leader. And then they had to shut down production, like I said, for legal problems. And when they picked it up about 10 months later, Charlie Sheen was then sort of more of the favorite, because Oliver Stone had decided that he wanted to kind of have a Charlie Sheen, Martin Sheen kind of relationship that's reflected in Apocalypse Now. Do you know what I mean? So it's like both Vietnam movies with Sheen people in it.
Do you ever look back at that and just sort of, like, how do you deal with that kind of regret? Or do you go, you know what, just wasn't my day, it wasn't my part? Because that would have been completely life-changing.
Yeah, you know, you really, I mean, you can do it, but it's not really a good idea to think about what didn't happen to you.
True,
the best thing to do is just be thankful for what did happen to you.
Oh, for sure.
And I know tons of actors that would give literally their left arm to have been in a movie as successful as Gremlins, shown every Christmas and basically has, you know, is going to immortalize you for the next, you know, 50, 100 years or something like that. They'd kill to have a massive, massive hit like that. And that kind of a thing really generally only happens, you know, once a lifetime if you're lucky. You know?
Yeah, for sure.
So I'm pretty happy with it.
Yeah. I think your Platoon story would be a story for a lot of other people who went, I was this close to Gremlins.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, you obviously starred alongside Corey Feldman in Gremlins and were pretty close with River Phoenix, who both battled drugs, drink, and I guess their own demons. How did you manage to escape that lifestyle?
Well, to be honest, I was participating in that lifestyle and I just happened sort of to be lucky enough to, you know, come to a point in my life where I sort of said, what am I doing? You know, you had that moment of clarity where you wake up and you clean yourself up and you pull yourself together and you don't fall into a trap like that, because it's very easy. You know, you're out there in LA, you know, you have no support structure, you're a kid, you're a knucklehead, you're in your early 20s, you don't know what you're doing. I mean, it's all new to you and people are telling you all of these things. So I just was kind of fortunate that I had a good upbringing and had a family support structure so that I could kind of snap myself out of it and say, dude, what are you doing?
Yeah. You are so lucky because, as we said, you were very close to River Phoenix. That must have been heartbreaking to see his demise, because he was such a promising young actor.
Well, you know, when I worked with River, he was maybe 14, 15 years old, I think, in 1984. And I was 20. So he was like kind of like my little brother on the set of a TV movie that we did called Surviving. And after that, I saw him pretty much on and off every year until he passed away in 93. So I wouldn't say I was his best friend, but I would certainly say that if I saw him on the street, we would, you know, walk up and hug each other and smile and hold each other's shoulders and look at each other and say, how you doing, bud? And he's like, good. And what are you doing? And how are you? And how's your family? So, you know, he was a real sweetheart. And it's just it's a devastating loss, really. Even today, it's a tough thing to think about.
Sure it is.
You have such an incredible backstory. Will we see Billy return for Gremlins 3 if it happens?
Well, I don't really know, but I would say this. Pretty difficult to write Billy out of a Gremlins 3 because he's so aligned with Gizmo. You probably have to have him at least in there for a little bit if you're going to snatch Gizmo away from him. So I imagine that if there's a Gremlins 3, you're probably going to see the Billy Peltzer character in some form or another. At least I hope so.
Well, maybe you should write it. Try yourself in it.
You know, what's really funny is actually, it's funny you said that. I actually sent a treatment to Warner Brothers one time, like, hey, it's Zach Galligan from Gremlins. Here's my Gremlins 3 treatment. And whoever I sent it to was like, not so much.
Aww.
Well, we'll see now.
We're down for it. We'll support you.
100%.
Tell us where to sign. You are delightful, Zach. Thank you so much for joining us today and chatting about the history of Gremlins and your fascinating career.
It's hopefully the future of.
So interesting. We can't wait to see what happens with Gremlins 3.